Today we're talking about Jeff Sessions, one of the many people to lose their jobs last night. Don't worry, it's not the first time Trump's lost a house. Alright, now Jeff Sessions had a long history of creating all sorts of policies and contributions that almost nobody cares about. I'm sorry to say, Jeff, but your legacy lies with the one thing you didn't do, the Russia investigation. Yeah, we're still investigating that, because, well, I'm sure we're gonna find a critical piece of evidence we'll be able to convince Republicans that
they are the fake, disgusting news.
Yeah, that checks out. Basically, it feels like we're doing this so that our history books will have a more fleshed out bibliography. So first, let's catch up on the Russia investigation, because it's been strange. The last time anyone heard about it, it was busting people for tax crimes, like the most boring episode of Law and Order.
The conviction of Paul Manafort is another blow to President Trump and a boost for special counsel Robert Mueller. Manafort was among the first charged as a part of the special counsel investigation, and now Mueller can claim a win in court despite sustained attacks by President Trump.
Yes, Mueller can claim a win in court because he caught an objectively sketchy dude on bringing money into the US without paying federal taxes. What does that have to do with Trump and Russia? Well, it was a crime that was uncovered through the investigation being used to compel cooperation, and this is what's really getting Trump worried. The authorization for Mueller to investigate couldn't have been broader if it was written by Hillary Clinton. It's one page, triple spaced, with some margins you could fly an airplane through. But it says that this investigation can look into any links or coordination between the Russian government and individuals associated with the campaign of President Donald Trump. Well, that makes sense. I mean, this is a Russia investigation. Any matters that arose or may arise directly from the investigation. Okay, ding ding ding, there we go. Have you ever tried to research on Wikipedia? One minute you're looking at the bond yields for the Philippine Central Bank, and the next minute you're on the character bio of James Bond's archenemy Jaws. Well, that's kinda how special counsels go, which is why you can end up going from an investigation of a shady real estate dealing to...
Indeed, I did have a relationship with Ms. Lewinsky that was not appropriate. In fact, it was wrong.
You know, for an embarrassingly long time, I thought whitewater was referring to a different white fluid. But it turns out it's a development company in Arkansas. Lastly, this investigation has the authority to prosecute federal crimes committed in the course of and with the intent to interfere with the special counsel's investigation. You know, your run-of-the-mill perjuries, obstruction claims, that sort of thing. This leads to critics, specifically those with big brains and the best words, to criticize presidents for speaking out to special prosecutors.
Paula Jones is a loser, but the fact is that she may be responsible for bringing down a president indirectly. And, you know, that statement was a bad statement to have been made, and it's proven to be false.
But he denied it, which is if you're in a hole, stop digging. Well, is there a certain point where you have to just sort of walk away from the deal and say, I'm not dealing here anymore, I'm going to... drop this line.
Well, I think his little speech afterward was a disaster. It wasn't the right tone, and I'm not sure he should have done it. And I'm not even sure that he shouldn't have just gone in and taken the Fifth Amendment and said, look, I don't get along with this man, Starr. He's after me. He's a Republican. He's this, he's that. And, you know, just taking the Fifth Amendment. It's a terrible thing for a president to take the Fifth Amendment, but he probably should have done it.
Currently, this investigation is trying to investigate two people, Roger Stone and a fake ID salesman with no connection to the Trump campaign. Now, I could leave it right there because frankly it would be funnier if it was just some guy, but unlike everything else in the news, this investigation seems to follow a logical through line. The same day he pled guilty, 13 Russians and 3 Russian business entities were indicted on conspiracy and fraud charges. Now, a key factor of Russian businesses is the fact that they exist in Russia, so don't expect to see them in court anytime soon. But it is good to finally know that businesses in Russia are corrupt. Who knows, maybe soon we'll learn the Pope is Catholic. The other big legal battle going on right now is Roger Stone.
The New York Times is reporting special counsel Robert Mueller is now looking into whether informal advisor to the Trump campaign, Roger Stone, had the inside track to WikiLeaks in 2016. with prior knowledge of the group's plan to release those hacked DNC and Hillary Clinton emails.
Stone, seen here doing his best impression of an innocent man who won't be related to impeachment, is the target of this investigation. It seems that the special counsel might be able to get proof that Roger Stone knew WikiLeaks was going to leak Hillary Clinton's emails to the public while working for the Trump campaign. And if they can prove that, they can finally slap collusion charges against Roger Stone? Well, that's a little bit underwhelming. Overall, this investigation has been pretty secretive, so I can't tell you much more than that. A lot of people think they might be subpoenaed, but who knows? I have a feeling Don Jr. just thinks everybody wants to talk to him. The major crimes this investigation is trying to prove at this point are breaking federal election law. Specifically, it's a crime for a foreign national to give money or other things of value in an American election. Second, violating the Computer Fraud and Abuse Act by potentially helping Russians hack and distribute emails. And lastly, conspiring either to commit any offense against the United States or to defraud the United States. Now that last one might sound a bit tinfoil hatty, but what it actually means is that Trump was aware or helping the Russians do the things listed above. The punishment for these crimes, if you can prove the president did them, some harshly worded 2020 campaign ads. The main thing to come out of this investigation so far are a bunch of lower level convictions on unrelated charges and potential arguments for obstruction, and a lot, I mean a lot of perjury charges. So now to the question on everybody's mind.
What's going on?
What's going on?
What is going on?
This is where things get a little tricky, because a lot of things hinge on a lot of other things. For example, did Sessions resign or was he fired? That might sound like asking whether someone lost your money in a fire or a flood, but control of this investigation could hinge on it. As we all know, the official reason Jeff Sessions recused himself was because he was heavily involved in the Trump campaign, and was totally unrelated to the multiple undisclosed meetings he had with Russian officials during the campaign. But in his defense, he was very involved in the campaign, and they were also very involved in the campaign, so it's almost inevitable that their paths would cross. So, alright, Sessions was forced to recuse himself because of all of the conflicts of interest. Your boss is being investigated for something you'd be implicated in, maybe sit that one out. And this put control of the Russia investigation in the hands of soon-to-be ex-Deputy Attorney General Rod Rosenstein.
And the big and growing question of what role did Russia play in the 2016 presidential election and any attempt to influence its outcome, a very important figure is about to emerge, and he's somebody most Americans have never even heard of. His name is Rod Rosenstein.
Just a brief segue. When I talk about this, people generally ask me, is Rosenstein pro or against Trump? But that's like asking if an accountant is pro or against taxes. He might have an opinion, but this is his job. We're talking about a Trump-appointed Republican Attorney General here, and not the type of guy Democrats would play the fight song before introducing. He's in charge of this investigation, and considering he's still there, what's the issue? The controversy is, you know who has two thumbs and hasn't recused himself from this investigation yet? This guy.
Can Matt Whitaker, the new acting Attorney General, end the Mueller investigation?
Well, I'll tell you.
That is never the best way to start an answer to that type of question. Did your friend kill that man? Well, I'll tell you. That was Ken Starr, Clinton's special counsel, and the rest of his answer answered that question without answering that question.
Well, let's wait and see. I know a lot of conclusions are being drawn in light of what the comments that Mr. Whitaker has made, his writings and so forth, his being critical of the Bob Mueller investigation. But there's so many traditions of the Justice Department, and Mr. Whitaker is now a part of that.
So he totally can do it. But don't worry, Democrats, because you have government norms to protect you. Which is about as reassuring as the voices in my head telling me I'm completely sane. So he can do it, but will he? Again, considering he's a caretaker attorney general until the next gets selected and approved, the answer would generally be no. We've already seen.
Democrats are already calling for Whitaker
to recuse himself because of his past statements on another network.
Yeah, that's really happening, and pretty much the perfect reaction to the fact that that is. Some Democrats like Chuck Schumer are suggesting that Whitaker recuse himself, because apparently he hasn't been paying a bit of attention for the last year. Well, that and the fact that he has made critical comments on the investigation a while before having the job, even going as far as suggesting ways for the Attorney General to shut down the investigation. Which, I guess, is grounds for recusal. His main stated problem with the Russia investigation is,
we do know how Whitaker feels about this because he's already said that he thought that if Mueller investigated Donald Trump's finances, that that would be a red line. And that he thinks that Mueller has come dangerously close to a red line. He thinks that the parameters should be much more narrow for Mueller. Doesn't that tell us what he's going to do?
Narrow the scope of the Russia investigation to investigating Russian collusion in the 2016 election? How controversial. You have to be naive to think that's exactly what's going to happen, though. But that's what's going to be the reason cited to shut it down. So what's keeping this investigation alive?
The nation is not just going to stand by and allow unilateral power to be exercised.
What can the nation do?
Oh, it's called the Congress of the United States. It's called the press. It's called the political pressure that the Justice Department will in fact experience if there is a non-merits-based action by the acting attorney general, if it is done simply out of loyalty. But we have no reason to think that that will happen.
I wonder what the rent situation's like for the rock he's clearly been living under these past few years. This guy seems less special counsel and more special counsel. So what can you do? If you really like this investigation, pressure Congress and the Justice Department. And if you really don't like this investigation, well, remember to invite me to the party you'll be throwing in a few weeks when it's over. In my opinion, there's a more important concern, though, whose answer may lie with the question of whether Jeff Sessions actually wants to spend more time with his family or not. First, legally speaking, nothing wrong with Jeff Sessions retiring. And if Sessions was fired, that would be totally legal too, and generally uncontroversial if it weren't for this darn investigation. There's a be careful what you wish for if I've ever seen one. And thank you for underlining that, just in case anyone missed your overall point. The longer term question is, who's gonna be the next Attorney General? And here's Alan Dershowitz to calm everybody down.
We don't know who the president's gonna appoint. He doesn't have complete free reign. There are enough Republican senators who wouldn't let him appoint a crony, who would at least insist that the person appointed be somebody of distinction and some degree of independence.
Oh, I guess his kids are going to have to keep running Trump National for the time being. This is where us constitutional wonks start having fun and society starts panicking. Because under the Federal Vacancies Reform Act, Trump can appoint an acting official without Senate confirmation if he replaces someone who has been incapacitated or resigned. It doesn't apply if the previous official was fired. And one of those questions that I'm constantly surprised hasn't come up during the first 250 years as a country, can Donald Trump appoint whoever he wants to be the acting attorney general if the previous one quit under suspicious circumstances? Now, I already hear some of you typing, nothing suspicious about this, and legally speaking, I would probably agree with you in most cases. Except for the fact that Sessions began his resignation letter by saying he was leaving at Trump's request. Come on, man, haven't you ever lied about being dumped before? It was mutual. It's always mutual. Either this was a final revenge or Attorney General just didn't know the law. Not sure which one to hope for. So that's what's going on in the quest to replace Jeff Sessions. Thank you, and that's all I have to say about that. Hello YouTube, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you want to support independent, nonpartisan comedy news, remember to subscribe by clicking on this floating logo to the right of my head. Or do it the old-fashioned way by clicking the subscribe button below. Ring that bell so that freedom will continue to ring, and remember to give me a thumbs up if you like what you saw. Lastly, as always, thank you for watching.